Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the current mirrors and we will see that how it can be designed using the MOSFET. So typically in the integrated circuits, the MOS amplifiers are biased using the current source. And typically in the ICs, this current mirror circuit is used as a current source. The advantage of biasing the amplifier with the constant current source is that it provides the high voltage gain and it also improves the biasing stability. In the earlier videos, we have seen that actually how this current source can be implemented using a single PMOS transistor or using the cascode current source. But in this type of circuit, this biasing voltage should be as stable as possible. So if there is any change in this biasing voltage, then it will affect the bias current. And it is particularly important in the battery operated devices, where with the time, the supply voltage reduces. Well, there are ways to minimize the change in the biasing voltage, and let's say somehow we are able to keep the biasing voltage stable. But if you see any IC, then it contains hundreds or thousands of such amplifiers, and each amplifier is operating at the different operating point. So to generate a stable biasing voltage for each amplifier is another challenge. Moreover, this drain current or this biasing current of this current source is a function of temperature, because this mu n and the Vt are the temperature dependent. So because of that, with the temperature, this biasing current will change. So to overcome all these problems, what is actually done is, a very stable current source is generated in the IC, and using the current mirror circuit, a copy or the number of copies of this reference current source is generated. So this generated copy could be same as the reference current source, or it could be a multiple or the fraction of this reference current source. So now let us see how this current mirror circuit is designed using the MOSFET. So we know that the MOSFET is a voltage control device, and in the saturation, the drain current ID can be given by this expression. So by controlling this gate to source voltage, this drain current ID can be changed. So if you want to copy this reference current in this MOSFET, then first of all, we need to generate a voltage which is proportional to this reference current. And we need to apply that voltage between the gate and the source terminal of this MOSFET, so that this drain current is a function of voltage VGS, and in a way, we get a relationship between this reference current and this drain current. So using the diode connected transistor, we can generate a voltage VGS which is proportional to this reference current. So in this diode connected transistor, the drain and the gate terminals are connected together. That means in this case, this voltage VD is equal to VG. So here, this voltage VDS is always greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. That means this MOSFET always operates in the saturation region. And therefore, this drain current ID can be given by this expression. So let's say these device parameters is equal to K. That means the drain current ID can be given as K times VGS minus VT whole square. And here, this drain current ID is equal to I reference. That means I reference is equal to K times VGS minus VT whole square. Or we can say that this voltage VGS is equal to square root of I reference divided by K plus VT. So depending on this reference current, this voltage VGS will change. And the same voltage VGS can be applied between the gate and the source terminal of this MOSFET. So let's call this MOSFET as the reference MOSFET and this MOSFET as M1. So if these two MOSFETs are perfectly matched, or in other words, if the device parameters of these two MOSFETs are identical, then for the same voltage VGS, this MOSFET M1 should also generate the drain current which is equal to the reference current, right? So here, the only thing which we need to ensure is that this M1 should remain always in the saturation, so that it can be used as a current source. That means this VDS1 should be greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. So in general, let us find the relationship between this drain current ID1 and this reference current. So let's say for two MOSFETs, except the W by L ratio, all the device parameters are same. That means the oxide capacitance and this threshold voltage are equal. So for the given value of the voltage VGS, the reference current or the drain current of this reference transistor can be given as I reference, that is equal to half times mu n times Cox times W divided by L reference times VGS minus VT whole square. While for this transistor M1, this drain current ID1 can be given as half times mu n times Cox times W divided by L1 times VGS minus VT whole square. So this W by L1 is the W by L ratio of this transistor M1, while this W by L reference is the W by L ratio of this reference transistor. So if we take the ratio of this ID1 and the I reference, then we can say that this ID1 divided by I reference is equal to W by L1 divided by W by L reference. Or we can say that this ID1 is equal to I reference times this W by L1 divided by W by L reference. So if the W by L ratio of the two MOSFETs are same, then this ID1 is equal to I reference. And by changing this W by L ratio, we can generate the new current, which is multiple or the fraction of this reference current. For example, if the W by L ratio of this M1 is 5 times the reference transistor, then this ID1 will be equal to 5 times I reference. So in this way, we can generate a copies, which is fraction or the multiple of this reference current. So typically in the ICs, the length of each MOSFET is kept fixed and only width is varied. And by changing this width, we can change the W by L ratio. Now, so far in our discussion, we have neglected the effect of the Channe and modulation. That means we have assumed that in the saturation region, even if the voltage VDS increases, then also this drain current ID remains fixed. But actually, the drain current does change with the change in the voltage VDS. So if two MOSFETs are identical, then this drain current ID1 will be equal to I reference, and it will occur when this voltage VDS1 is equal to VGS. So considering the Channe and modulation effect, it is true when this voltage VDS1 is equal to VGS. Because for this reference transistor, since the drain and the gate terminals are connected together, so the voltage VDS is same as VGS. That means for this MOSFET M1 to generate a same reference current, the voltage VDS1 should also be equal to VGS. But if there is any change in this voltage VDS1, then the generated drain current will also change. So if this voltage VDS1 changes by delta VDS1, then let's say the change in the drain current will be equal to ID1 plus delta ID1. And with this change in the drain current can be written as I reference times 1 plus lambda times delta VDS1, where this lambda is the Channe modulation coefficient of this M1. So we can say that the change in the drain current is equal to I reference times this lambda times delta VDS1, or we can say that it is equal to I reference times this delta VDS1 divided by VA, where this VA is equal to 1 over lambda. And this VA is also known as the early voltage. So this is the expression of the change in the drain current due to the change in the voltage VDS. Now, while writing this expression, we have assumed that the W by L ratio of these two MOSFETs are identical. But if the W by L ratio of these two MOSFETs are different, then let us see the general expression of this drain current. So in that case, this ID1 plus delta ID1 can be written as I reference times this W by L of first transistor divided by W by L of this reference transistor times 1 plus lambda times delta VDS1. So in this way, with the change in the voltage VDS, there will be also change in this drain current. So this change can be minimized by increasing the length of these MOSFETs. That means in the W by L ratio, if we increase the value of L, then we can minimize the effect of the channel and modulation. So on the second channel, we will cover a few examples based on it so that it will get more clear to you. Alright, so far we have seen the current mirror circuit using the NMOS transistor. Similarly, let us see the PMOS current mirror. And for time being, let us neglect the effect of the channel and modulation. So here, this reference current is connected at the drain terminal of this reference transistor, while the gate and the drain terminal of this reference transistor are connected together. So basically, it is the diode connector transistor. And if you notice over here, then the source of both transistors are connected to the VDD. That means here, voltage VSG for both transistors are equal. Now once again, this drain current ID1 can be given as W by L of this first transistor divided by W by L of this reference transistor times I reference. So the only thing which we need to ensure over here is that this M1 should operate in the saturation region. That means here, this voltage VSD1 should be greater than or equal to VSD minus VT. Alright, so now let us see the circuit where using a single reference current source, a multiple copies of this current are generated. So here as you can see, using a single reference current source, a multiple copies are generated. So here, this ID1 will be equal to W by L of this first transistor divided by W by L of this reference transistor times I reference. And if you notice over here, then the same voltage VGS is also applied to this transistor M2. That means for this transistor M2, this ID2 will be equal to W by L ratio of this second transistor divided by W by L ratio of this reference transistor times I reference. And the same current is also flowing through this transistor M3. That means here, this ID2 will be equal to ID3. So now this current ID2 will act as a reference current for this PMOS current mirror. And here, this ID4 can be given as W by L ratio of this fourth transistor divided by W by L ratio of this third transistor times ID2. So now let us put some numbers so that it will get more clear to you. So let's say the W by L ratio of this M1 transistor is 2 times this reference transistor, while the W by L ratio of the second and the third transistor is equal to 3 times reference transistor. And let's say for this fourth transistor, the W by L ratio is 6 times reference transistor. So with that, this ID1 will be equal to 2 times I reference, while this ID2 and the ID3 will be equal to 3 times I reference. And this ID4 will be equal to 6 divided by 3 times ID2. That means ID4 will be equal to 2 times ID2. And since ID2 is equal to 3 times I reference, so we can say that this ID4 will be equal to 6 times I reference. So in this way, we can generate a multiple or the fraction of this reference current source. So the only thing which we need to ensure over here is that all the MOSFETs should operate in the saturation region. Alright, so now this current ID1 can be used to bias the source follower, while this current ID4 can be used to bias the common source amplifier. And the same is shown over here, where this ID1 and the ID4 are generated using the current mirror circuits. So for this common source amplifier, this PMOS current mirror can be used as a load. And using the small signal analysis, if you find the equivalent impedance, which is seen from this drain side, then it is actually the output impedance of this M1. Let's say that is equal to RO1. So if we use this PMOS current mirror as an active load, then the voltage gain of this amplifier will be equal to GM2 times this RO2 parallel RO1, where this RO2 and the GM2 are the output impedance and the transconductance of this amplifying transistor. So in the earlier videos, we have seen that to improve this voltage gain, a cascode amplifier along with the cascode current source can be used. But in that case, there will be an issue of the biasing stability. So if we want to improve the gain and the biasing stability at the same time, then the cascode current mirror can be used as an active load. So if you want to know more about it, then let me know in the comments. But I hope in this video you understood what is current mirror and how it can be designed using the MOSFET. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.